good, they smackable.
Number one record, the chip record, record, so add it up.
Trapping at the gas stations, customers, customers lined up.
Yo, what up? I'm Christian Baki with the next video, and today I'm about to do something I never done before. You know what I mean? Recently, if anybody have me on Snapchat, they saw that I recorded the Snapchat Q&A video, but like it kind of messed up. You know what I mean? Because when I was recording, come to find out when it's time to edit, I put the videos on the computer. I came to find out that my damn mic was muted. Nigga, I recorded like 3 videos that day, nigga. So anyways, right, I'm about to do something I never done before. I'm about to do like sit down video with y'all. Something, I'm just talking about my life, whatever, and why I started YouTube, you know what I'm saying? Stuff people ask me every day. So that's what I'm gonna do real quick, you know what I mean? So I still have the snaps which y'all send me. I still got the snaps. So I could go back in this video, answer some questions by y'all which y'all send me from Snapchat. So because I don't wanna waste y'all time. I don't want y'all to be sending videos to me on Snapchat. And it'd be like, Christian don't even answer the videos. Like, we did this whole Q&A thing and Christian didn't even do it. You know what I mean? I still have it. So I'ma answer it after I answer some questions right now where people have been asking me, you know what I mean? Let's start off with the first one. They said, why did I start YouTube? I get this one a lot, bro. People ask me why did I start YouTube? And I answer this a few times. When people ask me why did I start YouTube, I don't give like the full reason of why I started YouTube though. You know what I mean? Why did I start a YouTube, bro? YouTube is something I always wanted to do. And that's one of my regrets, bro. I wanted to do YouTube about could be like 5 years ago. I wanted to do YouTube a long time ago, but I was too scared, nigga. I was like, Christian, nigga, you're too ugly to do YouTube. Nigga, you're too shy to do YouTube, but you know what I'm saying? I hold that off until about 6-7 months ago. Like FoozyTube, Roman Atwood, like I was watching them. Like in Mr. Got Jokes too, I was watching them before it was that popular. I never thought pranks back then was fake. So bro, I used to enjoy them videos back then. I never even knew they made money from YouTube, to be honest. I just thought, you know what I'm saying, they're doing this for fun or whatever. You know what I'm saying, etc. But hey, and a little story about myself, you know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna come on this camera and say stuff everybody be saying. You know what I mean? You ask someone about their story, a black person, let's say that, because a lot of black people say that. You ask a black person about their life story, and I bet you they'll say something like this. Man, I came from nothing, and I remember I didn't have nothing to eat one day. That happened to me before. But I'm not gonna come here saying no sob story, because I don't want nobody to feel bad for me. You know what I'm saying? It's not like that. I don't care. I'm not gonna say, nigga, I came from nothing, bro, and I had nothing to eat one day, and I had to beg people. No, it's not, you know what I'm saying? I always thought I was an entertaining person. I loved to tell jokes at school. Like, people know me for that. I always was the person, and I like to entertain people. I wasn't no class clown, you know what I'm saying? I was smart in school somewhat, you know what I mean? I never was dumb, but I love to tell jokes. I love to entertain people I think I realized that from the 10th grade, probably. You know what I mean? From there. And I was good at it. Like, my whole class amongst me knew that, hey, Christian, nigga, this nigga funny. You know what I'm saying? This nigga, I wasn't the most popular. I wasn't the most good looking. Y'all saw me. I wasn't the most good looking. I wasn't the most popular. But, you know what I mean? They know me for that. Christian, nigga, he's an entertaining nigga. Like, when he talk, he funny. You know what I'm saying? He tell y'all a story. He's funny. That's what he knew me for. So, yeah, I always knew I was an entertaining person. But then again, I was shy. And I told y'all this a lot of times, bro. I was a shy person. I still got a little bit shy in me. But it's not bad. It's, you know what I'm saying? It's not bad like how it was, bro. Nigga, you give me $100 to go walk up and talk to, just say hi to a girl, I would never do that. Now, man, shoot, I'll do that quicker than quick. I'm not a shy, but by then I just used to be a shy person. Y'all know what type of family I come from. You know what I'm saying? My mother, nigga, she ruthless. My mother and father, they disciplined me well back then. You know what I'm saying? And which I believe in that. Listen, something off topic again. Nigga, damn, I have children. I gotta discipline them. How I was disciplined, nigga. You know what I'm saying, bro? We say anything on the line, we get slapped quicker than quick. That's how it was. You know what I'm saying? So I come from that type of family. I wouldn't say shirk, but discipline well. You know what I'm saying? Cause back in the Bahamas, nigga, you could beat your children there. You know what I'm saying? This ain't in the Bahamas. Ain't like no damn America. You could beat your children. Damn, nigga, you could leave marks on them in the Bahamas. You know what I'm saying? You could do that in the Bahamas. America, you can't do that over here. You know what I mean? I come from that disciplined type of family. My father left us. My father left us when I was in the 8th grade. We just started really talking about when I was coming out of school, you know what I mean? I haven't heard from him about 4 years, 9, 10, 11, 12. 4 years. 4 years, we haven't really heard from him, and I didn't really care. Y'all know me, I don't care about, like, if my father chose to leave us, I don't really care, bro. I never one day when he left, I was like, nigga, damn, this nigga, like, he really went. Like, I'm saying, I don't care, bro. Hey, nigga, if you leave, that's you. You know what I mean? Probably I would care more if it was my mother. You know what I'm saying? I probably, but I didn't really care. You know what I mean? I never had no sad days. My brother, my sister, They care about it more. It hurt them more. It affect them. 4 years ago, he hit me up and I come to Georgia. You know what I'm saying? I came to Georgia twice before I decided to stay. The first time I came to Georgia, I didn't really know my purpose. I didn't came here for nothing. You know what I'm saying? The second time, same thing. I usually buy clothes with all my damn money. All the money I made, I bought clothes, shoes. That's why I have all them shoes right there. I come from this family, nigga. Y'all know how our roaches is. You know, we come, nigga, the house back home. Sorry to say, my mother, she hate me talking about how the house looking, like how the house condition. She hate me talking about that. You know what I'm saying? She feel embarrassed, but it's cool. One day, I'm gonna move out of the house. She don't want to move, but I'll move her one. I'll do something. I'll renovate the flick. You know what I mean? I'll renovate it. Because, nigga, damn, y'all know how the roaches is. Them roaches, they be like your best friends back home in the house, bro. You know what I'm saying? Bro, you roaches running across you 24-7. I don't know why. I don't know. They're just friendly for some reason, them roaches back home. But, hey, I'm going to move her. I'm going to pay up. I'm going to do something. Something where she live better. Because she got a lot of bills right now. I would love. That's one of the reasons I want to do YouTube. You know what I'm saying? Y'all may say, hey, Christian, so that means you want to do YouTube for money? No, that's not the case. I don't want to do it for money. It's not that. I just would like from the money that I pay some her bills. Christian, have you gave her money since you started YouTube? Yes. So yeah, I didn't come from much. You know what I mean? I did the stuff most black people love to complain about. They be, hey, Christian, nigga, damn. I didn't have nothing to eat one day. Like, yeah, everybody faced that. At least I think. You know what I mean? In my opinion, everybody need a little bit of struggle to them. Like, if you go throughout your whole life and you never had a struggle, bro, I don't think you dateable, if you ask me. Nigga, you know what I'm saying? You gotta have a struggle, bro. Off topic again. I don't think I can marry someone who never had a struggle before, bro. I've been through many struggles, bro. They said, do I do YouTube for a living? When someone asked me that, I said it was complicated. Because really, it's a no and yes. Recently, since I bought my camera. Y'all know, if y'all have me on Snapchat, y'all know when I got my camera. Since I got my camera, I've been doing YouTube more than I used to. Back then, before I got these equipment, nigga, I only could record at night in my bathroom. That's what I was doing. You know what I'm saying? Now I could record in my room. I open up the lights, you know what I'm saying? I don't have no lights yet. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm so ugly. But you know what I'm saying? I you know what I'm saying? Y'all niggas know, okay? Damn. From since I got these equipment, I've been getting the chance to work on YouTube more than I used to. Cause back then I only was doing it probably 3 times a week, I could say. And bro, I'll tell y'all this now. I believe that. That's what I believe. And anything you do in life, there's gonna be at least something. One thing. It's gonna be at least one thing. Some people love more things, but it's gonna be at least one thing to make your journey hard. Now I don't think nothing is given easy. Nothing is gonna be easy. It's gonna be something like, hey, you wanna be a basketball player. It's gonna be something, if not a lot, it's gonna be something that make your journey hard, nigga. It's gonna something that make your journey hard to get where you wanna be. To get into the NBA. You know what I'm saying? To get whatever, wherever y'all go. It's gonna be something. And bro, I tell you this right now. That's something in my life that's making this YouTube journey hard for me. That's something that is hard for me to get where I wanna be is my father, bro. I swear to God. I don't wanna go in detail when it comes to that, but that's the case, bro. That is the case. So I don't do YouTube for a living because I don't do it every day. You know what I'm saying? I'm not doing it. I'm not supporting myself with this. Not yet. You know what I mean? Not yet. I'm not making enough money to support myself well. So I'm not saying I'm doing it for a living. But then again, I am. You know what I mean? It's what I do with all my time. But then again, my father's still paying bills here. My father, he's buying food. So I'm not saying, hey, I'm doing it for a living. I'm not really supporting myself all the way. Hey, I'm not broke. Don't get me wrong. I'm happy where I am now. I'm not broke. I'm not rich. I have more money than I used to have. I was broke back then, nigga. You know what I mean? Back then, I couldn't go to the shop and say, hey, should I buy the juice? Now I could buy the juice. Like, what's your goals? You know what I'm saying? My goals in YouTube, bro. Damn. My mood probably full of calm today. That's gay. Okay. My future YouTube goals, I would like to say, I don't care about being someone who have a lot of subs. When I say a lot of subs, I mean like, hey, 6 million, 7 million. I don't care about having all that. I just would love to support my family. That's number one. I would love to be known for something in this YouTube world thingy. You know what I mean? Not just, hey, I'm a YouTuber. I want to be known for the funniest YouTuber. That's probably far-fetched, you know what I'm saying? Some of y'all niggas probably like, hey, nigga, that ain't never gonna happen for you. I want to be known for being the funniest YouTuber. Anytime y'all think funny YouTuber, anybody up there, anybody, hey, Christian, that's the first thing y'all think of. Christian, funniest YouTuber, oh dear, you know what I mean? That's what I want to be known for. You know what I mean? Saying this is a sit-down video. I always wanted to sit down and just talk to y'all, you know what I'm saying? I'm not talking slow either. Y'all know how some of them YouTubers, when it's time to talk about something, they be like this. So guys, I have something to say. It's hard for me, man. It's hard. Like, they be talking so damn slow, I'd be like, nigga, come on, we have stuff to do. Like, hurry, you know what I'm saying? Speed this up. You don't know how to go, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I'm not like other YouTubers. I love to think. I don't think so. I answer everybody back, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'll take 10 minutes out of my damn day to answer someone back, bro. Someone. You can't get a YouTuber to talk back for you for nothing, nigga. You can't get a YouTuber to answer you back for nothing. And guess what? Guess what they'll be doing? They love to make memes for their fans. For instance, I'm not talking about them, but for instance, they got the 18, the Chan Fam, the Dom, the Nation. Y'all know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? They got memes for their fans, bro. They say in their videos, hey, I love my fans. I can't, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be nothing without my fans. My fans, maybe where I am today. But I bet y'all niggas now, if y'all messaged anybody who's saying them stuff, I bet you y'all wouldn't get an answer back from them. We could even make a deal right now, bro. I'll give anybody a shout out in my next video. Do this for me, right? I don't want to put this nigga on the spot, but I'll do it to him. You know what I'm saying? This nigga right here, Damien. Message Damien, right? On Snapchat, right? Y'all know we love to talk, but I love the Nation, and I wouldn't be nowhere without the Nation. I love my fans. Y'all, message this nigga on Snapchat. If he answer you back, screenshot it and send it to me. It gotta be today. You know what I'm saying? Screenshot it and send it to me. Screenshot the date, screenshot the time. I need to know that it's real, because nigga, you can't Photoshop that. You know what I'm saying? Because I know how to Photoshop that. Don't Photoshop that thinking, you know what I'm saying? You gotta screenshot some stuff. I gotta know that it's real. If you could do that for me and send me it, I'll shout you in my next video. I know how it is. They don't answer people back. They don't. YouTubers in general, bro. I don't think any answer people back, to be honest. I don't know of no YouTubers that answer people back. No, I know. Corey from Kalina Corey, she answers people back all the time. Chandler, you know what I'm saying? She answers people back. Kelly Sweet, props to her. Who else I know? Damn, that's all I know. So, hey, message that nigga. If he answer you back, screenshot it and send it to me. If he do that, bro, I'll shout you out in my next video. Nigga, I doubt that nigga even have his DMs open, to be honest. Because I know they don't want people to message them, so they close it. But what they do is they follow people on Twitter. They do that. But then they still don't talk to nobody. So what's the point? I have the story about this nigga, right? Back then, before I did YouTube, I never told a story before. Back then, before I did YouTube, before I started YouTube, right? There was this guy, he did hair tutorial videos. He did hair videos. I don't want to call his name because I don't want to give this nigga no publicity. You know what I'm saying? He did hair tutorial videos, right? And I remember watching his videos all the time, bro. Nigga, I love this nigga videos. This nigga, I don't know. He just was one of my inspirations. And he did not a lot of subscribers. You know what I'm saying? He did not all them stuff. But I love watching him because, nigga, he had some good hair, bro. I'd be like, nigga, your hair. This nigga got some good hair, bro. You know what I'm saying? So, 2 weeks in. That's probably 2 weeks in, right? I started YouTube. I probably have like 2,000 subscribers. He had like 20,000. I DM him on Instagram, right? I say, hey, bro, I love your videos, bro. Let's do a collab. I'm not trying to get clout from him, because I told him it's not because of your number. I don't care about your number. And then really, I don't care about numbers now, bro. I'll collab with anybody if you could make me laugh. I don't care if you have 1 subscriber, 100 subscribers, 200 subscribers. I'll collab with anybody that make me laugh. You gotta live in Atlanta too. So yeah, I don't really care about numbers, bro. But hey, apparently that nigga care about numbers. Cause I was like, nigga, let's do a collab, bro. Not really because of your number. I don't care about your number. I'm not trying to get clout off you. Let's do a collab, bro. Let's meet up. He live in Atlanta too. Let's do a collab. Let's do that. This nigga ain't answer me until I pass him in subscribers. Months down the line, bro. This nigga literally opened my message and did not even answer me back. So I guess he went on my page. He saw that I had 2,000 subscribers, he had 20,000. He was like, nigga, what's the point? No, which is cool, I don't care. But down the line, when I pass him in subscribers, he messaged me back. Hey, okay, let's do it, bro. And I'm saying, like, sorry to answer so late. You know what I'm saying, bro, I didn't even answer that nigga back, bro. That's how they like to do. People look down on you because of your number. I want you to know, that's how them bigger YouTubers are. You know what I'm saying? You can't get no collab with them because they feel like, hey, I better than you. That's how it is. And let's move on to the Snapchat ones.
Hey, man, what's up, man? I don't have a question, but just want to say I love your video. You're really good. Yeah. What's your favorite song by Migos?
Thanks for the support, by the way. Who's that? What's his name? Well, I forgot the name. Thanks for watching my videos, bro. You know what I'm saying? Thanks, you know what I'm saying? Thanks for enjoying them. Because I love people not only to watch my videos, to enjoy them. One of my biggest fears is that I hate these words. This is one of my biggest fears. I hate these words. Christian, you fall off. So anytime I feel like I put a good video out like last week and I come today and I post a video that ain't that good, you know what I'm saying? This probably ain't good as my last video. I'm not trying to be funny in this one. I just want to talk to y'all. I want y'all to know me as a person. I don't think I never did this before. That's why. So I don't really care about this one, but I love to try and make it better than last week. I know I don't hit that mark all the time, but I don't want to be so bad. Like people be like, nigga, you fall off. Like what the hell is this? I'm saying I don't like stuff like that. So that's one of my biggest fears, bro. People saying you fall off.
What's your favorite race of ankles?
My favorite race of ankles. My favorite race, bro. I don't discriminate when it comes to ankles. If you could have one hairstyle forever, what would it be? Twists. I'm saying these don't look good right now because damn, I had these in for like, I think it's been almost approaching a month. Nigga, my mo dry. It's something again, bro. People ask me this. I wouldn't say all the time, but when they do, it gets me mad, bro. When people ask me this, they be like, Christian, if you've been growing your hair for 1 year and it's been 1 year and 10 months now, if you've been growing your hair for 1 year and 10 months, like, why is your hair not even long? Like, how could you make hair tutorial videos if your hair ain't long? How could you show people how to grow your hair when your hair ain't even long? I don't get this a lot, but when I do, it gets me mad, bro. I told people this 100 times, nigga. I cut my hair 4 times, nigga. I gotta write that at the bottom because I don't think people understand. I cut my hair 4 times. 4 times throughout this hair growth, I cut my hair. So really, I haven't been really growing my hair for 1 year and 10 months. Not really. I grow my hair to 5 months, the woman cut it. I grow my hair to 2 months, the woman cut it. I grow my hair to 4 months, the woman cut it. I grow my hair to like a month, the woman cut it. Zoom, 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 and she'd cut my hair low. She'd cut my hair about that length. So nigga, stop asking me. Twist. If I pick anyone, I'll have that. Is that a real accent? Nigga, so you mean to tell me I have the same voice in all my videos and I never broke it once? Damn. To be honest, you're my favorite YouTuber and I get so excited when you come up with another video. Like I be on YouTube, like when is he gonna post another? Your videos are so funny and lit, and I don't know who else I watch if you weren't on YouTube. Nigga, thanks, you know what I'm saying? you know what I mean? Thanks though, you know what I'm saying? You the best. Thank you. And I don't know about the last part, you say you wouldn't watch, I don't know who to watch if you weren't on YouTube. Damn. It's like that. Nah, me. I love the support. Yes, a lot of white people do hit me up for hair questions. A lot. What's your favorite song from culture? My favorite song from culture.
Yeah. Hold up. Get right with you. I'ma get right with you. Bad bitches, fuck them, then dismiss them. Bad. Really here to take no pictures. Flash. Middle finger up for the system.
Y'all niggas know I gotta go with that Get Right With Ya. You know what I'm saying? That Get Right With Ya. Y'all thought I wasn't gonna dance in this video, right? So y'all thought I wasn't gonna dance in this video.
Hit the face. Hit the face. Damn. Oh shit. Oh. Likely. Hey, y'all. Okay.
Hey, I don't dance like that, okay? I'm uglier than that. I'm saying? You ain't that ugly. I'm saying you gotta be like, I'm saying you gotta come like this.
Nigga, you ain't Uzi, you ain't Cardi, damn, show not me. Never on the scene, what you mean? Nigga, y'all I mean. Falling like y'all mean, spin a face, nigga, just like Sting. Came up popping beans, then I dropped it cause I'm not a fan. All you niggas wanna be me, huh? Rub the pussy.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
I got so many decisions. Ravens fly with the pigeons.
I be the pop while you be the witness.
Try me with Don't and McKidness. I feel like a perk to calm my tensions. We pop it up in the city. I got your hoe in my DM. I got your hoe at my mansion. The plug, he live in my mansion. He got bitches in the kitchen.